Sunlight beaming forth in the east, far from the fatherland, bringing tidings of the new world to families in the field. Let us hasten to send the news all throughout the world. To bring into the heavenly, into the heavenly barn, and men of good homes gather to speed the task. All will share the harvest, the joy at the banquet of our Lord. Life tells the tidings. Tells the tidings of the rising sun that brings us
lying. God is an awesome God, he reigns. grace of God. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. And together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. And we'll know where God's children are. Our love, our love, yes, they'll know where God's children are. An awesome God, He reigns from heaven above and in the power and love. Our God is an awesome God. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity will one be restored. And they'll know where God's children are. Our love, yes, they'll know where God's children are. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above and in the power of love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above and in the power of love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Let's all sing together. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. There's revival and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the rhythm of a gospel song. Oh, once you choose it, you can't lose it. Oh, cause there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. When the valleys that I wander turn to mountains that I can't climb. Oh, you are with me, never leave me. Oh, cause there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. Oh, 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 oh. Clap your hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel, because it's all you'll ever need, all you'll ever need. Clap your hands and stomp your feet till you find that gospel, because I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. We've got the sweet salvation, and it's beautiful.
I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I got a sweet salvation, and it's beautiful. I got a heart overflowing, 'cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. Oh, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.
Oh, please be seated. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. In love, and You're slow to anger. Your name is great, and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness, I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to fight. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy near, and my time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. I'll worship His holy name. I'll worship His holy name. We'll sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship His holy name. I'll worship Your holy. Worship Your holy name.
Good morning. Let's give the band another round of applause. So good morning to those online, and good morning to those that are here today. So my name is Taka. I will be your MC today. And thank you. So for today's sermon, we are going to welcome up Jonathan Jesper.
Good morning. Ooh, that sounds good. Good to see you. Hi, Zoom people. We love you. We'd love to see you here, too. Hope everyone's staying safe, doing well. Man, it was fun having our band back. That was fun. That was some energy. It was great. Yeah, thank you for all the work and preparation that went into that. This time of year, we have a lot of holy days coming up. There's like Foundation Day, True Parents' Birthday, Cosmic Peace, something. A lot of holy days. But we also have another, one of the holiest days coming up too. And in America, it's a Super Bowl Sunday. And so we like to announce that we're going to host a Super Bowl Sunday party. We're going to have a whole Sunday service. So that Sunday service, it's 2 weeks from now on the 13th. I think it's 2 weeks. And we're going to hold it here at IPEC. So we're going to start with coffee at 12:30. And then at 1:30, we're going to have our service. So those of you that are like, ah, service is too early, no excuses on that day. And then after that, we're going to break off and have a big old party. We're going to bring in food. We're going to put the game on the projector screens, turn up the sound. We'll have a betting board. Those of you that are like, well, I don't know about football, we'll have a presentation. We'll explain what football is. It's great. We're going to have a great time, community event. So to prepare for the Super Bowl right now, there's been some epic games. Has anybody been watching football? Wow. So a bunch of you are going to have a lot of fun on Super Bowl Sunday. We have about 15% of our audience, I think, that are watching the football games. Well, it's the playoffs. And in the playoffs, the best teams are all competing. And the winner advances, and the loser, your season is done. And so everyone's just going all out, doing whatever they can, game on the line. And we had some epic games. The last round, last weekend, every game came down to a last-second field goal where you kick the ball and get 3 points, or a last-second touchdown. Incredible. And you watch these athletes. It's amazing what they're doing. On the highest of stakes, the biggest of stakes, the most pressure, they're just like, one game in particular was the Buffalo Bills and the Kansas City Chiefs. They have two. Do we have people from Buffalo here? Was it Kansas City? What got me the woo? Kansas City? Okay, that's the one. Okay, great. Yeah, the Kansas City won, but these quarterbacks are just going back and forth. One would throw a touchdown. Everyone's like, dang, oh my gosh, that's the winning game. And then 13 seconds left, the other quarterback's like, not today, and came back and led his team down the field. It was amazing. It was probably that game had the most perfect quarterback play in the history of like football. And I'm watching it, these athletes are doing it, almost looks effortless. Like they're not even trying. It's just second nature. And we think, wow, watching, they make it look so easy. Those athletes are so great at what they do. But what you don't see is in order for them to get to that level, all the countless hours and years of practice that they did to become experts at their craft. Literally, they spend, to make that perfect touchdown pass, what people don't see is they practice that again and again. Every day they're out there throwing the same route, the same pass, becoming an expert at it, so that when the game is on the line and the pressure is intense, they know how to respond. It's like muscle memory. I think there's a keys to that. That in order for them to be good, they have to do the same thing again, repeat it again and again. And I think it's got to be sometimes frustrating or even getting boring. The same passes every day. If you think about a musician, your favorite musician, they have a list of like, maybe if they're at a concert, they do 10, 12, 14 songs. They sing those songs every single day. They practice it every day. They repeat it. Again and again and again until it's second nature, and they never, ever stop. I think sometimes we get success confused. We think in order to be successful, you have to be ultra talented and you have to have this advanced, fancy techniques. And I think that's what keeps people stuck. Because we have the wrong viewpoint of success. See, number one is we think success is an advanced tactic. What is that secret in order to be successful? What is that like ultra complicated thing that you're doing that makes you great, and how do you do it? Maybe you have a favorite video gamer. Maybe you've watched him on Twitch. I've never gone on Twitch in my life. I know, I'm 33, almost 34, pretty old. But we think, oh man, maybe they're just such an advanced gamer. They know how to do all these fancy things with the buttons. We don't see that they practiced it. So what keeps us stuck is, number one, we think success is some advanced, far-off technique, strategy, or skill set. And number two thing that keeps us stuck is because we think it's an advanced skill set, technique, or strategy, we think, oh shoot, we can't do it. But the truth is, anyone that's an expert at their craft, they've mastered the basics. They practiced the fundamentals again and again and again until it's second nature. Anyone seen the movie Karate Kid? It's a really old movie now. When I was younger, it wasn't that old, when I was like 11, but now it's like, phew. Well, if you haven't seen the movie, and I'm not talking about the one with Will Smith's son, I'm talking about way back, because you guys may be like, oh, I know that old movie. Yeah, Will Smith's son, Jaden Smith or whatever. No, I'm talking about even a long time ago. Mr. Miyagi. There's this boy, he wants to get good at martial arts. So he goes to the guy, he's like, teach me, I want to be an expert. He's like, great, wash my car. And the boy's like, what? And then he's trying to wash. He's like, no, that's not how you wash the car. How you wash it is wax on, wax off. Great, wash my car. Boy does it. He comes the next day. All right, I want to learn this. Like, I want to learn the martial arts. I want to be a master. He's like, great, wash my car. Eventually, he gets resentful. But one day, it clicks when he's learning the martial arts. And he's like, when you get an attack, wax on, wax off. And all of a sudden, boom, the kid blocks a hip punch. And boom, he blocks a kick. And boom, he blocks. What he realized is, for him to be successful, he had to practice the basics. So success is not that difficult. It's not that tricky. That's the secret. And sometimes people don't want you to know that. But if you want to become the best at your job, your career, your relationships, with money, with anything, your spiritual life, it's really simple. What are the fundamental basic principles? And can you practice them again and again and again? If you want to be a master, you must master the basics. I one time heard a story from this guy, And he's really into martial arts too. So martial arts is a theme in this one. And he had an opportunity to learn from a Shaolin monk from the Shaolin temple. Apparently, I'm not an expert at this, but apparently it's like this super reserved temple, and it's very rare to meet monks. And they've perfected martial arts. Like maybe they can run up the walls and do all that kind of stuff. So he was super excited. He gets to meet a Shaolin monk. He loved martial arts himself, expert at it. So he meets this monk, and he goes up to this monk, and he's like, I'm so excited to meet you. He speaks to the translator, and then the translator is like, yes, it's a pleasure to meet you as well. I've been wanting to do this my whole life. Can you please teach me the secrets, martial arts of the Shaolin Temple? Oh, he's so excited. And the guy speaks, the translator goes, yes, he's willing to help you teach you some of these principles of the Shaolin Temple. Great, what do we get started? The translator goes, well, first, he wants to show you how to throw a punch. And the guy's like, a punch? No. You don't understand. I've been doing martial arts since I was 3. I know how to throw a punch. What I want to know is what are the secrets? What's the secret technique of the Shaolin Temple? The guy explains it, answers back. The translator goes, well, he wants to show you how to throw a punch. No, you don't get it. Translate differently, like, here, a different way of saying it. I want to know the secrets, the good stuff. Give me the juicy stuff, the hidden secret of the Shaolin Temple. It's going to give me my edge. He goes back. The monk stands up, looks at him, says something. The translator goes, okay. He wants to see you then throw a punch. Oh, great. I guess I can show him I know this, so therefore he can show me the secret stuff of the Shaolin Temple. So they light a candle, and he said, he wants you to punch your arm and go as close towards the candle and go to the close to the flame as you can without touching it. Fine. And the guy goes, "Shapoosh!" And his hand lands right next to the flame. Perfect. He's all proud. Feels great. That was awesome. And the monk gives a sly smile, talks to the translator, and the translator says, oh, he's impressed. You definitely know how to throw a punch. Yeah, great. Now can we? And he goes, now the Shaolin monk wants to show you how he throws a punch. So then he gets up, in one quick move, boom, doesn't even go near the flame of the candle, just throws a strike, and poof, the flame goes out. This guy's eyes get really big, and he's like, oh my goodness, how did you do that? I want to learn how to do that. And the monk, through the translator, then says, that's what he's been trying to tell you. He wants to teach you how to throw a punch. But it's not just a punch, it's a punch. And he then gave a really big words of wisdom. I am not afraid of the 1,000 moves that you know that you only practiced once. But I am definitely afraid of the one move that you have practiced 1,000 times. It's that mastery. It's finding the basic principles and becoming so good at it that you can do it in your sleep. And it's not complicated, it's not hard, but you just have to find what are those principles and just get so good at them. There's this saying, practice makes perfect. Have you heard it before? A few times, practice makes perfect. I don't 100% agree with that statement. I think perfect practice makes perfect. But if you practice the wrong way or the wrong things, then you become an expert at doing it wrongly. And maybe in your life, you can think of things that you do wrongly all the time that you've just become an expert at. Maybe you're an expert procrastinator. Maybe you're an expert at not following directions. Maybe you're an expert at being late. Maybe you're an expert at criticism. I don't know. You mastered those fundamentals. I know myself, I'm not that coordinated. I'm actually quite proud of all the things I've done in my life, considering how uncoordinated I am. When I was young, I even had to wear a brace on my leg because I wasn't able to walk straight. But so I figured out my way of doing things. So I have a very unique way of shooting a basketball. As a kid, I did it wrong so much that I got pretty good at it. But now that I don't play basketball that often, when I get back out on the court, man, I shoot, it's all inconsistent, it goes wrong, it goes, and I'm like, Jonathan, it's time you learn to do this correctly. But I've done it so many times the other way, it's so hard to change that habit. I also have an interesting way of throwing a football. I do more like a shot put kind of thing, but you're supposed to turn your waist, it's all in the hips, you're supposed to have your arm go more in a bigger release. I tried, people teach me, but I'm like, it's so hard. Why? Because I practiced the wrong way so many times. So what are the fundamentals? What are the things of our life? Well, in our spiritual life, every single thought leader I've ever studied from has said the key to really getting the most out of your life is to study correct principles and study them every single day. The founder of our movement, Reverend Moon, who we call True Father, he instituted a culture tradition called Hundoke. And it's in Hundoke that every day you're aligning yourself with correct principles that can serve you. One quote I want to share by Reverend Moon is, "Today is just the beginning. Pray to tell God that you are just beginning and need his help. Make a showdown with God every day. It shall become second nature. And without being conscious of it, you can live that life all the time." Yeah. It's about doing the things that serve you every day, making it a habit, practicing the correct thing again and again. And before you know it, you're going to become a master. And people are going to look at you and be like, man, that looks so complicated and hard, because you can do the advanced stuff. But the reason you could do the advanced stuff is because you practice the basics. Absolutely. How do you know when you're really mastering a basic? Because honestly, the basics aren't the exciting stuff. The basics sometimes get routine. They get boring. You know when you're ready, when you're mastering a basic, because it's not boring and routine anymore. In fact, you're excited to learn it. You can't get enough. Oh, please, teach me that again. Oh, how are you doing it? If you're playing piano, you just practice the same strokes, same keys, and you're just like, man, is there a better way I could do it? You're always looking, how can I improve? If someone has another idea, you're like, yeah, I want to hear that idea. Oh, this is so much fun. I love learning about and practicing the same thing again and again and again. Then you know you're mastering a basic, when it doesn't become work anymore. And when you're like, man, I could just do this forever, then actually you're ready to move on. But the weird thing is, you don't move on. You keep at the basics. Ooh, hello. I one time heard in our tradition, we have the spiritual training of fundraising. Anyone here ever go fundraising before? Wow, some of you, we have our next activity. I think some people are shy. I think we all have in some form or nature. And I read one time a speech where Reverend Moon shared, when you feel like you can dedicate your life to fundraising and you're just so excited to do it, that's how you know you're ready to move on from fundraising. I don't know. I don't think I was ready. I don't think I got that level yet. Yeah, me either. But some of you, you don't want to do the basics anymore. You don't want to hear it. You're like, oh man, that speech, I read it already. I sometimes talk to people and they're like, oh, Divine Principle Lecture. Yeah, I heard that one already. I heard it many times. I know it. Oh, you know it. Then you must have an absolutely principled life. You must have mind-body unity. Because you know it. Well, to know but not to do is not to know. I'll say it again. To know but not to do is not to know. We get stuck because there's a difference. When we say we know, we mean we got it up here. But see, your life is not dictated by your intellect, your mind. Your life is dictated by your soul. And so when we learn things consciously here, that's some level of knowing. But it's when it hits your heart, that's when you shift. Have you ever had that experience? Someone said something, and it's something you've heard many times, but they said it in such a way at just the right moment that when it hits you, you're just like, boosh, like a shift. That ever happened to you? What happened at that moment, it didn't just hit your intellect anymore. It went into your heart. You emotionally and spiritually made a connection, and your spirit shifts. It grows. Well, how do we do that? How do we get that level of understanding? There's only really one way, and that's repetition. It's doing things again and again and again. So one thing I want to invite everyone, I've been sharing it every week, and I'm going to keep on sharing it because I'm all in, is I want to invite all of you to a course. This is a course that talks about the fundamentals, the basics of how to practice unconditional love in our lives. My wife and I have taken this course. We've been studying these materials. We've seen tremendous growth in our own lives. We've also shared it with others in like unadulterated magic. If people apply it, if they practice them, if they master them, their life improves. These fundamentals are how can we experience God's unconditional love and practice it in our daily life. So we're going to do a group study, a course, and already a lot of you have signed up already. It's going to be pretty exciting. I'm stoked for the momentum that we're having. We did make a change though. We are going to start, instead of February 5th or 6th originally, we moved it to the 19th because there is holy days. And so we want to have momentum where we can do it every week. So we have a foundation day on the 12th. So we're just going to start it the week after on the 19th. So if you signed up, you'll get an email confirming the change. But that's going to be our time. We're going to do it Saturdays from 1 to 3. And it's really for everybody. If you're single, it's perfect. Because these are the fundamentals that you're going to bring into all your future relationships. These are the fundamentals of practicing unconditional love that you're going to bring into your future marriages and family and everything. If you're married, it's great because now you can work on it and work it with your spouse and apply it to your families. You'll see results. If you practice the basics and fundamentals, if you master them, you see results. It's guaranteed. If you'd like to sign up in your flyer, you'll see a QR code. You can scan it. Now, some people messaged me and they're like, I have a dinosaur phone. It can't scan. So if you have a dinosaur phone, we put a link in there as well. It's pretty long, but we'll also send it out through email as well in the e-news. If you're still having trouble, just get in contact with me and message me. You are what you practice every single day. Some of you are looking at that and go, oh, that's a typo. Well, actually, I learned something while researching for this sermon, that there's two ways of saying practice, and one is the British way. And I think we changed it in America. So just to be safe, I spelled practice with both a C and an S in the sermon. But really think about your life. Where do you want to make a shift and a change? What do you want to see different? And just go to those fundamentals. Master them, and you will not, and as you master them, your life will change. And you can experience a level of happiness and joy that you hadn't before. But the key is, keep practicing the basics. Thank you very much. Okay, join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Parent, we're so grateful to be here today, and thank you for this opportunity that we get to come here as a community to be able to share and to love and to have joy and hope and inspiration. Heavenly Parent, as we are going, we want to become masters of the basics. We want to know the principles that can lead us to have happy lives and experience your love and joy. Please guide everyone here that our hearts can be open, that we can be willing to change and willing to practice new things, that we can grow together and learn together. Really, at this time, this is such an amazing time we're living, a settlement time where we get to experience your ideal. Guide us so we can become these masters and practice it every single day. I want to thank you and offer this prayer in my name and all our names. Amen and adieu. Adieu. Thank you.
Thank you, Jonathan. So now we will start our offering. So we have an offering basket to your left and my over there. And you can also text a dollar amount to 702-820-5511. And then while we are doing our offering, Jonathan has prepared a perisher question. It is, what is something that you love to practice over and over again? So you can turn to your neighbor, discuss a little bit. What is something that you love to practice yourself over and over again? What fundamentals are important in your life to become the person that you want to be? All right, thank you everyone. Now for our announcements. Is there any newcomers, or are there any newcomers or returning friends today? Anyone?
Anybody? Okay.
All right, we have someone. Okay.
Want to stand up? Introduce yourself.
My name is Prince Adeyemi.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Anybody else?
He's the top dressed in our Sunday service, I think by far. We need to have a runway for this guy. Anybody else? We haven't seen you in a while.
I haven't been here for a while. Hello, my name is Takayoshi Hirano. I'm the son of Futoshin Sita Hirano. I just heard that House Sunday Service has been great, and I want to thank Jonathan Jasper for doing this and investing a lot. But yeah, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to participate. And thank you.
Awesome. See us again. Okay. Last second. If you say something, you get lots of friends. Okay.
All right. Next up. Who had coffee this morning? Starts 9:30 every Sunday. So it's gonna be downstairs in the bar, the coffee bar. Next up, we got a Super Bowl party in 2 weeks. It is a community building event. So for those that do not know much about football, I may prepare a special presentation to explain the game to you. So Service is going to start later, as you can see. So coffee is going to be at 12:30. Sunday service at 1:30, and the Super Bowl party will be at 2:30. There'll be food and kids' room, so please bring a donation for food. Next up, we had meetups this week. Share your stories and pictures at that website down there. Next is Mimi Morris in the room. We would like to thank her for leading Golden Cranes. Thank you, Mimi-san. And Gloria Sato will be heading that up from February 1st. Next, as Jonathan has talked about, we will have the Essentials of Real Love starting on the 19th of February till March 26th. I know it says 12 on there, but it's the 26th. So it'll be every Saturday from 1 to 3 p.m. Location will be at Chenghua Gung, so True Parents House. Who can attend? It's anyone from 12 to 107. So I believe none of you guys are 107, so you guys are all welcome. And then for those young children, we'll have babysitting provided. Holy Day celebrations, we have True Parents Birthday on the 6th of February. Foundation Day is on the 13th of February. Heavenly Parents Day, True Parents Day, True Parents Holy Wedding Anniversary is on the 16th of April. And let's welcome back up the band.
Before that, we want to sing happy birthday to the January babies. Whoever was born in January, please come up to the stage. We want to offer this song to you. Any January babies?
Who's born in January?
January.
January babies, come on up. If you're a January birthday, come on up.
They're here.
Born in January.
Wow, we have a lot of January babies. Half the church, a quarter of the church.
Yeah. February might be more lonely.
I got the... Do I light it? Oh, you got it. Thank you.
All right, let's light the cake.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, January babies. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, January babies. Happy birthday to you.
All right,
let's go.
Lean in. And let's blow out the candles. Yeah. Just don't blow any COVID, okay? Count to three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to babies. Happy birthday to you.
One more time.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, January babies. Happy birthday. To you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you.
Thank you, January.
Thank you, happy birthday, January babies.
To you.
All right. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Let's go. Let's all rise. Let's close the service with a song.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, not the sun in my eyes. And I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason heaven is clear. It's because you are here. You learn love and I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Such a feeling.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I see. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Top of the world.
I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Your love's put me.
Your love's put me at the top of the world. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Great to see everyone. Remember, keep practicing those fundamentals. Join us for pizza and snacks in the back. Have a great week. And remember, you are so adorably loved. Have an awesome week.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. And a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. Reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are. creation and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, but the sun in my eyes. And I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I see. I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is a love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is a love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody on Zoom.
Thank you, guys.
Everybody on Zoom. See you. See you next week. Bye.